talk show host Rush Limbaugh and anti-war vets are escalating their war of words today after Limbaugh's comments appearing to call veterans critical of the Iraq mission, quote, phony soldiers. But now some of those soldiers are firing back in a new ad from VoteVets.org. Take a look.
More and more troops and veterans of Iraq believe George Bush's military policy has been a disaster. I am one of them. Rush Limbaugh called vets like me phony soldiers for telling the truth about Iraq. Rush, the shrapnel I took to my head was real. My traumatic brain injury was real. And my belief that we are on the wrong course in Iraq is real. Until you have the guts to call me a phony soldier to my face, stop telling lies about my service.
Well, Limbaugh responded to the ad yesterday with these comments about the vets who appear in the ad.
You know, this is such a blatant use of a valiant combat veteran lying to him about what I said, then strapping those lies to his belt, sending him out via the media and a TV ad to walk into as many people as he can walk into.
Well, it should be noted that the Iraq vet in the ad suffered his injuries in a suicide bombing. Joe Watkins is an MSNBC political analyst and former aide to President Bush, 41. And Brandon Friedman is vice chair of Vote Vets and is the author of The War I Always Wanted. Thank you both for joining me again.
Thanks, Tamara.
So, Joe,
thanks,
you heard Rush Limbaugh's response to the ad that just came out. It's a tough situation. What do you think? I mean, is this an unnecessary fight for both sides?
Well, you know, it is, I think. I think that it's so unfortunate that that Media Matters and others have just taken off after Rush Limbaugh like this. And I think that all of us as Americans honor the people who put on uniforms and who represent us and who put their lives on the line for the rest of us in defense of this country. We all do, I think, and I know Rush Limbaugh does as well. It's just a shame that the comments he made were taken out of context and now are being used to create this big firestorm of controversy. I think it's just a huge distraction.
But, Joe, you know, Rush Limbaugh's not running away from the controversy, and that's where I want to bring you in, Brandon. Is your organization and some of the Democrats playing into Rush Limbaugh's hands in that you are responding and keeping this going?
No, his comments, first of all, weren't taken out of context. If you look at the transcript, he didn't bring up the soldier that he is using as his excuse until 2 minutes later. And then yesterday, when he attacked the soldier that was in the ad challenging him, and he compared him to a suicide bomber, that's completely unacceptable. And I would hope that Joe could agree on that, that's unacceptable for discourse, you know, in public.
Joe, what do you say to that?
Really disparage soldiers like that.
Brandon, let me get Joe in. What do you say, Joe?
I would never disparage soldiers. I don't think Rush Limbaugh did either. I think that Rush Limbaugh certainly is not at all shy about fighting with people who miscast his comments. And really what this is, and I think Rush Limbaugh would agree, is this is the attempt of the left, of many on the left, not all, but many on the left, to try to get back for the MoveOn.org controversy that took place a couple weeks ago.
But Joe, what he says in the comment, he says phony soldiers. If he's only talking about one soldier, Jesse McBeth, why not just say phony soldier, that guy, Jesse, you know, who lied about his record? Well, later, like 2 minutes later.
Yeah, about a minute and 35 seconds later, he started talking about Jesse McBeth, because Jesse McBeth is the kind of person that he was talking about. He's somebody, of course, who represented himself as a soldier.
He knew he was in trouble.
He fought in Iraq and obviously didn't, and now has been prosecuted for lying.
So, Brandon, why not direct your anger at the Democrats in Congress who have not been able to change the path of the war in Iraq, made some promises, and have not been able to keep those promises to the American public? Why go after Rush? He's not your guy. Why not go after the Democrats?
Well, we go after the people who have put us in this position in the first place, the people who have formulated these policies in the beginning, like the president and like the Republicans in the Senate who have blocked the bills we've tried to get through. Rush Limbaugh is an enabler, and he has a big voice, and he enables these policymakers. So we go after the policymakers that don't support the military, and we go after people like Rush Limbaugh.
Because the things Rush is saying are
unacceptable.
Tamron, these veterans who are out there are heroes, and we honor their service to this country. But right now, they're heroes that are being used, unfortunately, by folks on the left who are trying to attack Rush Limbaugh. I believe you are. I believe that you're being used. I think your service to this country is honorable and admirable, and for you to be used by the left to attack Rush Limbaugh and
now,
to
you have no idea what you're talking about when you say that I'm being used.
I'm not being used. I'm talking about. I mean, I think that the folks who have served in honor of this country deserve to be honored. But when you get to the point where all your attention
until
is
you've gone over there and served in Afghanistan and Iraq like I have, you don't know what you're talking about. Well, because I'm not being used. I've been over there and I've seen it with my own eyes, and I'm not being used. These are my own opinions.
It's a perfectly honest debate to talk about whether or not we should be in Iraq. There are people who think we should be there, and the people who don't think that we should be there. That's an honest debate. But to try to distract America into fighting with Rush Limbaugh and by miscasting his comments is a way to get people on your side. I think it's a huge distraction. It's a huge distraction.
No, Rush Limbaugh brought this on himself when he compared somebody who challenged him to a suicide bomber. And this is a guy who was injured by a car bomber in Iraq. And that, there's no place for that.
Well, you know, Joe,
I would hope that you could agree with that.
Well, I agree that there's that people who have who've been injured in service to this country are heroes and ought to be honored as such. But that doesn't mean that that they can be used. And I think in this case, many of you are being used by the one statement he made, phony soldiers.
Well, we're
and
we've
talked about Jessica Beth.
No. Guys, we're out of time. And, of course, very passionate on both sides. Brandon, you've said that the vets are hurt by what they perceive to be Rush Limbaugh's comments. Joe, you've got your feelings on it. But thank you both for talking with us.
Thanks so much, Tamron.
Certainly.
Thanks for having us.
Thank you, Brandon.